Bhagavad Gita, 7th chapter, fifth shloka, fifth verse. Apareyam itastvanyam prakritim viddhi me param jiva bhutam mahabaho yayedham dharyate jagat. This upper lower itah from this anyam different jiva bhutam life element my param higher prakritim prakriti viddhi no mahabaho o mighty armed yaya by which idam this jagat universe dharyate. Earlier Sri Krishna in the third verse has told how it is difficult to understand in principle the supreme reality, and in the fourth verse he has given the reason for that, saying that prakriti is divided into 8 parts, and 8 parts starting from egotism, mind and intellect, and then the 5 elements. And so it is difficult for a person to concentrate on the principle of reality. But then the question might arise, why would then someone try to concentrate on the principle of reality when the universe is divided into 8 parts? Why not try to understand those 8 parts? And what is the prayojana or purpose of understanding the ultimate reality? And so in this verse, Sri Krishna clarifies this. He says that prakriti, my prakriti, has got 2 levels. One is the lower level, another one is the higher level. So there is something which is real in prakriti, there is something which is apparent in prakriti. So one has to understand not the lower but the higher prakriti. And what is the higher prakriti? So he is saying this is the lower prakriti. That means the ashtada prakriti bhinna ashtada, that prakriti bhinna ashtada bhinna, eightfold prakriti, or the prakriti divided into 8 parts, that is the lower prakriti. This is apara. So this is lower, and there is higher prakriti. Higher prakriti is what? Higher prakriti is jiva bhutam, the principle of self-consciousness, the principle which is the basis of the entire universe. That is the higher prakriti. And so that yaya idam jagat dharyate, by which this jagat or universe is sustained, that is the higher prakriti. That though it is true that prakriti is divided into 8 parts, and though that might and that does become obstacle in understanding the ultimate reality, even though that is the case, one has to concentrate on understanding the higher nature of prakriti, which is self-consciousness. Because why should, again the question might arise, why should one understand that? One should understand that because that is what dharyate jagat, that is what holds the entire universe, that is the basis of the entire universe. If we go to the classic example of Vedanta, there is the rope which is mistaken to be snake. If there were no rope, there would be no snake. If there is no Brahman, there would be no universe. So Brahman is both the Nimitta and Upadana Karana, both the instrumental and material cause of the universe. So that is what is the basis of the entire universe, and that is why it is important to understand it. Etad yonini bhutani sarvani ityupadharaya aham krishnasya jagatah prabhavah pralayastatha. Sarvani, all bhutani beings, etad yonini, of which these two prakritis are the womb. Iti, this upadharaya, no, aham, I, krishnasya, of the whole or the entire jagatah, universe, prabhavah, source, tatha, and also pralayah, and also dissolution. So, Sri Krishna is telling that my prakriti has got two aspects. One is the lower aspect, another one is the higher aspect. And you understand or know that these two aspects are the womb of all living beings. And I am the origin and the dissolution of the entire universe. Krishnasya jagatah prabhavah pralayah tatah. That I am prabhavah, source, tatha, and pralayah, dissolution of the krishnasya jagatah, of the entire universe. So the entire universe is born from me. When now Krishna says me, what does it mean? This me means the ultimate reality, Brahman. So Brahman, as I just told, is both the upadana karana or material cause and nimitta karana, instrumental cause of this universe. Just like we see in the example of snake and rope. If there is no snake, there will be no rope. And it is because of the snake, that is the material of the snake, that there is rope. And it is because of the presence of the snake that there is rope. But there is no rope. The rope is adhyasita, superimposed on, sorry, there is no snake. There is no snake. There is snake is adhyasita or superimposed on the rope. Snake is superimposed on the rope. So without the rope, there will be no snake. Both the material and the presence of the rope is necessary. Similarly, without the presence or the existence of Brahman, which alone is existing, and without the material, of course we cannot say that Brahman has any material, but without that there will be no source of this universe. This universe is similar in dissolution. When the universe does not stay, what comes? Nothing comes. Swami Vivekananda, while giving lectures on Jnana Yoga, in one of his lectures he gives an example that a teacher went to a class of a school and asked a girl. He asked the girl that why does not this earth fall? Earth is in the orbit of sun. Why does not this fall? So then the answer given was, immediately the girl asks a counter question. Where will it fall into? Means where will it fall to? Everything is space. There is no substratum where it can fall. So similarly, dissolution only of this apparent universe. Brahman cannot go anywhere because there is no place which is not Brahman. Everything is, see, if Brahman has to go somewhere, that means it is in a place where it is not there. Only there it can go. You are now sitting in Kolkata because you are not in Delhi. So from Kolkata you can come to Delhi. But if you are already in Delhi and also in Kolkata, how can you go from, suppose you are such a huge person that you, one feet is in Kolkata, another feet is in Delhi. Then how can you say I want to go to Delhi? You cannot, you are already there. Similarly, Brahman is omnipresent. It is the only reality. So it cannot go anywhere. So dissolution of anything happens, only that thing dissolves or only that thing is destroyed which has limit in time and space. Brahman is not dissolved, Brahman is not, does not undergo the process of dissolution. So it is both the source of the universe, it is also the place where everything dissolves into. And this, when the universe evolves out of Brahman, we see Prakriti. Ashtadha Abhinna Prakriti we see. Prakriti, the eightfold Prakriti we see. When there is evolution. On the contrary, when there is involution, when it goes back, we don't see anything. Because there is no we also. There is no seer, there is no seen. All the distinctions cease. And only Brahman remains. But when the universe is evolved, is there no Brahman? Brahman is always there. But this apparent reality is created. A false, apparent, illusory reality is created. And when there is involution, that reality ceases to exist. And only the absolute reality, the true reality, ultimate reality remains. So, this we have to understand, that these two prakritis are the womb of everything. Means what? The lower prakriti is the cause of this universe and the higher prakriti is the cause of everything. Then Sri Krishna says, Dhananjaya matta parataram nanyat kinchid asti dhananjaya mai sarvamidam protam sutre manigana iva. Dhananjaya, O Dhananjaya, matta, other than me, parataram, higher, anyat, else, kinchit, nothing, na, something, na, asti, is not there, sutre, on a thread, maniganaha, a row of pearls, iva, like, idam, this, sarvam, all, mai, in me, protam, is strung. So now the question might arise. You are saying that you are the cause of the universe. You are the source, you are the cause of the birth and also the death of the universe. Or you are the source of the evolution and involution of universe. If that is the case, what are you talking about these two prakritis? So this prakriti also is coming from you. Then you say that this prakriti is got, prakriti is the womb of everything. Then you say that the lower prakriti has got eight divisions. So what is this? Why so many divisions? And if there are divisions, does that mean that you are there or you are not there? Where is the question of division coming? So to clarify this concept, Sri Krishna says, wait a minute, even though there are two kinds of prakriti, higher and lower, and even though the lower prakriti is eightfold, it has got eight divisions, but it is not like division in time and space. Time we usually divide into past, present and future. Space we divide into here and there. So the place where I am staying or I am located, this physical form is located, is here. And the place where this physical form is not located is there. Time is what is now, what is happening is present. What will happen in the future is future. And what happened in the past is past. So at any given point, I am concerned with the present and my present place where I am located. So, I make myself different from my past and my future. At every moment it is happening. Okay, this distinction is happening. Is it in that sense that these divisions of prakriti or in the divisions of lower prakriti, higher prakriti, or the division of eightfold division of lower prakriti is happening, Krishna says no, it is not in that sense. Why not in that sense? Because again, going back to the rope and snake example, even when you were seeing snake and rope, the rope existed. Even when you were perspiring and you were afraid, the rope existed. When you wanted to kill the snake, rope existed. Then you understood that it is only a rope, even then it existed. The rope itself did not change. It did not change in the time when you saw the rope for the first time, and then when you understood, when you were afraid, then also it did not change. And when you understood the true nature of rope as rope itself, then also it did not change. Similarly, there is nothing other than me in this universe. Whatever you see is only rope. There is no snake. That means whatever you see is only Brahman, or there is only God. That is why the Upanishad says, Isha Vasya Midam Sarvam Yatkincha Jagatyam Jagat. In this universe, whatever is Jagat, ephemeral, temporary, changing, that you have to Ishavasyam, you have to cover it up with the Acharitavyam, means you have to envelop it, or you have to cover it with the consciousness of God. Why? Because that is what exists. Though through our five sense organs and the mind, which is the sixth sense organs, we perceive differences in the universe, but what exists is only one undivided, infinite, homogeneous consciousness. The Chaitanya only exists. And so Sri Krishna gives an example. So, in a letter to Mary Hale, sister, one of the Hale sisters, Swamiji writes, only God is. All this is not, only God is. All this is not means this universe is not actually true. Only God is true. So, matta parataram na anyat kinchid asti. There is nothing other than me. Nothing other than me. We see so many things. So, this would explain one doubt which you are asking me. That when we do something which is secular, the question. Now we are studying Bhagavad Gita. Very good. Our mind is in a higher plane. But when we do something secular, what is secular? I am watching a movie. It is secular. It is secular. There is no God there. If we say like that, it is illogical, because then God becomes limited. God becomes limited in time. God becomes limited in space. So though you perceive that as a movie, which supposedly is telling you something which you think is secular, is there any logic in telling that when I accept the infinitude of Brahman or God, when I accept that God is infinite, meaning that there is no limit in time, space and causation, when I accept that, is there any logic to say in the same breath that God is not there in a particular activity, God is not there in a particular place or in some particular time? There is no logic. It is completely illogical. So if you accept that God is omnipresent, omnipotent, if you accept the infinitude of God, that God is infinite, then it goes without saying that there cannot be anything, any place, any time or anything which is not God or which is different from God. Then the question might come, then why do we see something to be taking us towards God, taking us away from God? So that is difference only of ignorance. There is no difference in Brahman or God. What is the difference? Difference is only of ignorance. There is no difference in light. Difference is only of the curtain. If the curtain is, the veil is thin, there will be more light. If the veil is thicker, darker, there will be less light. So here the difference is only of ignorance. It is not about God. God is present everywhere. Mattaha paratram na anyat kinchit asti. There is nothing other than me. Everywhere only I exist. Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam Sarvam Krishnamayam. Everything is Krishna. Krishna means here we have to take not just as a personality but as the ultimate reality, supreme reality. So it is only Krishna which is there. Or so wherever my eyes fall, there I see Krishna. Wherever my eyes fall, I see Krishna. And wherever my eyes don't fall, there also Krishna. So this is the understanding. This is the understanding. How the example is given? Sutre manigana iva. Just like you have a necklace. Say you have a mala. You have a garland which you wear. Suppose it is a pearl necklace. So pearl necklace or you have some diamond necklace. In that diamond necklace, in all the diamonds, what is common? What is common? In the diamond necklace, all the diamonds are there. What is connecting them? What is common in them? How are those diamonds held on to in a necklace? How are they together? Metal or thread? So it is strung. So there may be different pieces of diamond, but all of them are put together by a thread. That thread could be silk thread or metal thread, whatever that could be. But that is a thread. Okay, so the thread, sutra. Thread in Sanskrit means sutra. So sutre manigana. So all this universe, the lower prakriti, higher prakriti, all this whatever you see, the different varieties of names and forms, nama rupa veda, all that which we see is nothing but different pearls or different jewels strung on the same thread. And what is that thread? That thread is Brahman. That thread is Brahman. That thread is Ishvara. That thread is God. So, what is common in the whole necklace? If that thread is cut, the necklace will all scatter. All the diamonds will scatter, everything will scatter. So what is common in that? Common is the thread. We are not going into what material the thread is made of. That is not of our concern. The thread, it might be of copper, it might be of aluminium, whatever it is. The thread. So the thread. So I am like that thread. How? Mai sarvamidam protam. In me, everything is strung. Just like different pearls or jewels are strung on a string, similarly in me everything is strung, and so mai sarvamidam protam. Everything that ever, whatever you see, what you don't see, what you perceive, what you don't perceive, what you know, what you don't know, everything is connected through me. Sri Ramakrishna puts it very simply. There are so many zeros are there. No use. Put one, immediately all zeros gain value. So, without God, there is no value. Why? Because without God, there is no existence. We exist because God exists. We get our identity because of Brahman. If Brahman is not there, we don't get identity. That's why Vedanta will say, Jiva Brahma Aikya, the identity of Jivan and Brahma. Jiva and Brahman. Why is there identity? Because it is because of Brahman that Jiva comes. It is like saying that the snake and rope are identical. Actually, there is no snake. There is only rope. By mistake, you see snake. By ignorance, darkness, etc., etc., you see snake. But that doesn't mean that the snake is different from the rope. Similarly, there is only Brahman. Because of ignorance, you see so many ramifications, varieties of names and forms. And so we should understand that there is no names and forms. There are no names and forms, but there is only Brahman. Sutre Manigana. This is often quoted and we have to understand it. So there is a common link between all things in this world. They may be living, they may be non-living. You are sitting on a chair, the chair is also conscious and you are also conscious. There is only consciousness. Difference is in ignorance. Logically, there cannot be any difference in consciousness. Where is the difference? It is in ignorance. It is in ignorance. Yeah, see, the differences are all illusion, that is correct, but we do see illusion, right? So when you see illusion, you cannot say that I am not seeing illusion. You will be a liar. You will be a liar. So you have to accept that you do see illusion. It is true that seeing the snake is an illusion, but you are seeing it or not? You are seeing it. You cannot say I am not seeing it. You are seeing it. You are seeing it. So when you see it, you have to remind yourself that it is illusion. That is what. So actually there is no snake, there is only rope. That is what we are doing here. That is what Sri Krishna is asking us to do, or asking us to do through his instruction to Arjuna, that Mayi Sarvamidam Protam. Sarvamidam. He does not say that only people who have life or things which have some activity. No. Sarvamidam. Whatever you see. My protam, it is connected to me. Whatever you see is connected to me. That is the idea. Sutre manigana eva. Like sutre manigana eva. Like jewels strung in a thread. So everything is connected to me. That is the understanding. Everything is connected to me. Or not connected to me. Everything is connected through me. I am there in everything. Elsewhere in the Gita, I will say, Hriddeshe Arjuna Tishtati. I am residing in the hearts of all beings. But that is only living beings. Here he is saying, Sarvamidam Protam Mayi. Mai Sarvamidam Protam. So, in me, Sarvamidam Mai Protam, in me everything is linked, strung. That is the understanding. So, now afterwards, Sri Krishna will go on explaining how he is one of the aspects of this creations, like in different aspects of creation, what he is, that he will explain. In many shlokas, we will see later. Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Tat Sat.